we'd taken our daughter Lila to the doctor a few times. She'd just been generally unwell. We couldn't work out what was wrong with her. And we were away on holidays and she was literally laying on the sun lounge next to me and not going in the pool. And she was nine and I thought, that's weird, like a nine-year-old not to be wanting to swim. So we took her straight up to the doctors and the doctor basically told us that she was an hour off a coma, that she had type 1 diabetes. I think I've never really felt more alone in my life. It was probably one of the hardest things, and people tried to help and they tried to support, but I don't think anybody can understand how hard it is. Every time you eat, you must count your carbs, you must inject insulin, you must learn how many carbs are in the meal, then what your blood sugar, and then test your blood sugar, plus then do your injections. It's a very big adjustment in your life. I was not surviving, I was exhausted all the time. Getting up not only to a baby, to also getting up to my daughter with type 1 diabetes every night. 1 hour was getting up to the baby, the next to feed, the next hour was to get up and check my daughter's blood sugar levels. And I just sort of was like, I can't do this anymore, I don't know what it is. And I literally just got up off the couch. My husband was just in the kitchen over there and I yelled at him, I'm gonna run a marathon. I wanted to run a marathon to create awareness for type 1 diabetes. I think not enough people knew the symptoms and I wanted awareness. I wanted to create awareness around what type 1 diabetes is. So I committed to running the Great Ocean Road Marathon. When I completed that, I decided that the following was just amazing and it was time to sort of make a change. And I committed to running then every marathon in Australia in a year. I think about lots of things. Some of my most amazing ideas have come from my long runs. One of the reasons I started the charity was on a long run, and I stopped halfway, took down some notes, and then kept running. The Type 1 Foundation is 4 years old now and has grown significantly. We fund and support equipment. We also create different ways that families can network and connect to each other. There's always something next. I don't feel that I can stop running. I think that running will always be something that I do, and where it takes me next, I don't know, but all I really want to do is inspire other people. Put one foot in front of the other and you never know. Fitness for me is a massive part of my life. It makes me a better mum, makes me a better person, a better wife, and a better director for the charity. My name's Ange Liston-McCaughley and I run for Type 1 Diabetes.